بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is the video for the Epithelium high power slides. We have 10 high power slides for the Epithelium. The first one of this is the simple squamous epithelium, which is formed of one layer of flat cells with flat nuclei. The picture for the simple squamous epithelium is taken from the parietal layer of the Bowman's capsule in the kidney. So these are the flat nuclei representing the flat squamous cells of the simple squamous epithelium. Simple because it is formed of one layer. And this is the most common site, which is the parietal layer of the Bowman's capsule. By the high power, you can be sure that it is flat nuclei, as the shape of the nucleus follows the shape of the cell. The second type is the simple cubical epithelium. And this is the slide of the thyroid follicles, filled with the colloid pink in color. And this is the lining epithelium formed of one layer of cells that have rounded central nuclei, which is characteristic of the cubical epithelium. So this is the simple cubical. This is the simple columnar epithelium, one layer of columnar cells. Here, this is one layer of cells, but they are taken at different planes, so not a thin section, so you can see many nuclei, but these are actually one layer of these tall columnar cells. The cell is very tall, and the nucleus is present at the base, and it is oval. The other type is the pseudostratified columnar ciliated with goblet cell. Different layers, presence of cilia, and the presence of empty spaces like this representing the goblet cell. So these combinations, different layers of the nuclei, the presence of cilia, and the presence of the goblet cell, this is the pseudostratified columnar ciliated. Then we have the non-keratinized stratified squamous. We have different layers, and the top layer is formed of flat squamous cells with flat nuclei, no keratin on the surface, so this is the non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, present in oral cavity, in esophagus, and as well as in the vagina, not covered by keratin as it is always wet and not exposed to wear and tear. While the keratinized stratified squamous formed of many layers of the cells, the top are flat squamous, as seen by these flat nuclei, and then above them we have a layer which is not nucleated, and it is pink. It is the layer of the keratin, and this is the keratinized stratified squamous, which is present in the epidermis of the skin. All of this is the epidermis of the skin, and the keratin is produced by the death of the cells. The transitional epithelium, it is formed also of many layers of nuclei. As you see, this is the basal and the intermediate and the top. The top layer here are formed of cubical cells with central rounded nuclei and not flat like the stratified squamous. So this is the transitional epithelium present in ureter and urinary bladder. So this is the transitional epithelium, many layers of nuclei, and the top layer is formed of cubical cells. The neuroepithelium, it is the epithelium modified to receive stimuli and give a nerve impulse. These are the taste buds formed of different types of cells. One of them is the sensory cells or the hair cell, present at the side walls of the papilla present on the surface of the tongue. So this is the papilla, and these are the taste buds, flask shaped. Then we have glandular epithelium. We have the serous acini. They are more or less basophilic, and as you see, we have these rounded nuclei, very evident. This is a duct, but these are the serous acini, to be compared with the other type, which is the mucous acini. The mucous acini here appear to be very pale, vacuolated, due to dissolved mucus, and they are having the flat basal nuclei. So it is completely different from the serous And this is all. Thank you.